James here. I'm currently traveling abroad and just woke up, but I wanted to sit down and make a video addressing everything that's going on right now. Because I owe everybody an explanation. But most importantly, I owe two important people an apology. To Tati and James Westbrook, I'm sorry for everything that is going on, everything that I've put you through over the past few weeks. I met Tati and James almost 3 years ago now, when I was first coming into the industry and when I had no friends and nobody to talk to or look up to. And Tati very quickly took on a parental role with me, because she knew my parents were across the country. And over the past few years of knowing her family, her and her husband have given me so much love and advice and opportunities and a place to stay and a shoulder to cry on at 3 in the morning and support when nobody else would or wanted to. And I'm so disappointed in myself that I ruined a relationship that did mean so much to me, even if I didn't do the best job of showing it all the time. And throughout all of this, what sucks the most is that I know there's nothing I can say or do to ever earn that friendship or trust back. But I don't blame you for it. A lot of my most of my career over the past few years has been about me making mistakes and trying to learn and grow from them. And I haven't always done the best job of that. I can admit that. But I haven't always tried. Because I know there's a lot of people watching me, and that a lot of people look up to me as a role model. And I hate knowing that I disappointed. Not only them, but most importantly, two people that have been role models to me doing this. I wish that I could say this is the last time that I would make a mistake, but it won't be. I know that I disappoint people more and more as I continue to learn and grow every single day. I have a long way to go. Very long way to go. Personally that I possibly can be. I'm sorry for that. In regards to the Coachella situation with the brand deal and the security guard, I know he told my truth about this twice. And instead of talking about it for a third time and explaining it and going into detail and pulling up receipts, it doesn't matter. And I understand that no matter what I say or do, there are always going to be people that don't believe me and don't think that I'm lying. And that's okay. At this point, the truth really does not matter. It's the feelings that do. And no matter what happened, I hurt two very, very important people. And they've been really, really loyal to me, and I betrayed that. And it sucks, and I wish more than anything that I could take it back. In regards to the boy situation, boys have been a topic that I've talked a lot about on my social media journey, and it's a topic that I wish I hadn't. I've been involved in a lot of very unique and strange situations that have left people confused or upset, and I've learned the hard way about ways that I can interact with boys that I'm interested in, and also ones that I should or shouldn't be talking to. This is a conversation that I know a lot of people are uncomfortable with, and it's one that I should have been far more careful with bringing into the public eye, especially with the last situation that just happened. I probably learned the hard way. But coincidentally, I've talked to really wants one of the people to sit me down and tell me how it looked from the outside, and let me know, hey, talking to these boys might get you in trouble one day. And she was right. In regards to my own mother, and fight for me and go off on comments, but I ask that you don't. This is my problem that I got myself into, and this is my job to deal with this. No matter what anybody is saying or commenting or talking about, Mom, I need you to know that you're the most important person in my life, and that you're an amazing mother. I'm so grateful for everything that you've done for me and the lessons that you've taught me and everything that you continue to do for me and my brother. And I need you to know that. I need you to know that. And the same thing goes for Tati as well, who is an amazing person and truly does what's best for everybody around her. I'm so disappointed in myself that I hurt her. A lot of times when I've had to address things in the past, I've acted out of impulse, and I've gone off and tried to pull receipts or facts or screenshots and play the victim. And I'm not doing that today. I'm not. That's what I have to say. I'm sorry.